Dear students, in this video lecture we will be discussing about the flywheel and turning moment diagram. Turning moment diagram may be a new topic for you, but flywheel is not a new one because we have seen the application of flywheel in many situations in our day-to-day life. Especially in sewing machine, we have seen the flywheel application. In sewing machine, we have a bigger wheel which is always rotating even though we are not pressing the foot pedal. Okay, because it will absorb the energy while we are pressing the pedal, and it will release the energy when we need for stitching. Okay, in the same way, we are using flywheel in many applications, especially in IC engine, steam engine, punching presses, etc. So flywheel is used to absorb the energy during the power stroke and release the energy during the other stroke. Because in IC engine, we have only one power stroke, but we are having the continuous motion because of the flywheel. Okay, only one power stroke is there, but for every cycles we have continuous constant power supply because of the flywheel. Flywheel is a machine component used to control the variation speed caused by the fluctuation of turning moment occurring during each cycle of the flywheel. Okay. Why we are having variation speed? Because fluctuation in torque. Okay, if we have continuous power supply, then there is no fluctuation in the torque. But in IC engine, we have only one power stroke. So for other stroke, we don't have any power production. So there is a fluctuation of torque. So that there is a variation in speed. But to get a constant speed or controlling the speed, we have flywheel. Because flywheel stores the energy when supply of energy is more than the required and release the energy when the requirement is more than the supply. So it is a reservoir of energy. Now turning moment diagram is used to design the flywheel. First of all, turning moment diagram is the diagram or pictorial representation of the turning moment versus crank angle. Okay. It can be defined as an area under torque and angle of rotation of the crankshaft, which gives the energy stored or given by the flywheel. It is also defined as the graphical representation of the turning moment or crank effort for various positions of the crank. Here, I have illustrated the turning moment diagram for 4-stroke IC engine. Okay, here in the y-axis, I have taken the turning moment. In the x-axis, this is crank angle. For various positions of the crank, what are the torque available in the IC engine? Okay, in 4-stroke engine, for obtaining one power stroke, we are having two revolutions of the crank. That's why here I have drawn from 0 degree to 4 pi, that is 720 degree. Okay, the first stroke is the suction stroke from 0 to pi, pi to 2 pi, 180 to 360 is compression stroke, and 2 pi to 3 pi. For next revolution, we have power stroke. This is positive loop, and next one is the exhaust stroke. Okay, here except the power stroke, for all other strokes, we have negative loop, because in these strokes, the work is done on the gases. In power stroke, the work is done by the gas. That's why we have positive loop here. Okay, in suction stroke also, we have some positive loop, and in exhaust also we have positive loop, but in compression stroke we don't have any positive loop, because in the compression the whole work is done on the gases. That's why it has a larger negative loop. Here this positive loop indicates the inertia of the crank. Okay, I have illustrated the inertia forces, including inertia forces, in the diagram. That's why we have positive loop here. For example, in the suction stroke, initially we have to do some work for the movement of the piston or movement of the crank. After that, due to the inertia of the crank, we have some energy. Okay, here we are not giving the energy. In the exhaust stroke also, we have some inertia force of the crank, so that this energy is not needed to given to the engine. Okay, so this is the turning moment diagram for 4-stroke IC engine. Now for little bit extra. Here I have taken the turning moment diagram for multi-cylinder engine for little extra knowledge about the flywheel. This is a multi-cylinder engine. Here we have positive and negative loop for each engine. Okay, let me take point A is the starting point of the engine. The energy available at A can be taken as EA, that is equal to E simply. Okay, next we have this much area as A1 as the positive energy, and after this BC have area A2. The same way here we have different positive and negative energies as the fluctuation of energy in a multi-cylinder engine. Okay, so from this diagram we will be understanding the concept of fluctuation of energy, especially the maximum fluctuation of energy. Okay, first one, point A, the energy is E. Okay, next for point B, in point B the energy is energy at A plus this A1, so E plus A1. Next at point C the energy is previously E plus A1 minus A2, because here it is a negative energy, A2 is the negative loop. Okay, next A3 is the positive and A4 again negative, A5 is again positive, and finally at G we have energy at the energy equal to energy at point A, because in this point the cycle is completed, again new cycle is started. So for one cycle in a multi-cylinder engine we have this much energy fluctuations. I want to know what is the maximum fluctuation of energy. Generally maximum fluctuation of energy means the difference between maximum energy and minimum energy, maximum energy and minimum energy. Okay, now here the maximum energy obviously this A plus A1. Why? After this here is the only, with the constant energy, this is the, this energy is added, after this the energy is subtracted. So this is the only maximum energy, and the minimum energy will be energy at point E, because after this we have added A5, so this cannot be minimum, and here this energy is equal to energy at A, so obviously this will be the minimum energy. So the difference between maximum energy and minimum energy is the maximum fluctuation of energy. If you subtract these two you will be getting A2 minus A3 plus A4. This is for understanding of the maximum fluctuation of energy in any engine. Okay, and one more thing, the main purpose of the flywheel is to produce this mean torque, because this is a torque we needed for the running of engine. This is the maximum torque in the engine, we are having the maximum torque at this point, and we don't need this much energy for all strokes. So what we are doing, for all other strokes this much extra energy will be supplied for the continuous rotation of engine. Okay, that is the function of flywheel. So the mean torque into the total angle, the mean torque into the total angle is the work done by the cycle. The mean torque in the total angle is the work done by the cycle. In the next video we will be discussing the important terminologies in the flywheel, so that you can easily solve the numerical in the flywheel. Thank you.